Hovatech. Just a button away.
In this tutorial, I will be explaining how to back up our MetaTech device firmware using WWL and SP Flash 2. I'll be using a secure boot device, so I will also use MTK bypass to bypass secure boot. So first, we need to have our VCOM drivers installed. We need to know how to disable secure boots or bypass it. We have a guide for that. I will add the link also. So first we go to our WWL to launch it. So when you launch the WWL2, you go to the auto mode tab and you generate an empty scatter file. So for the chipset, I'll be using MT6765. And for the memory type, EMMC. So click on create and save, and you choose the folder you want to install it, you want to save it. So I'll be saving it in a folder called ROM dump. So with this generated scatter file, we'll use it to get a preloader using SP Flash 2. So we open SP Flash 2 next. And we load the scatter file. So you go to the read back tab. So the name of the readback will be ROM1. You can use any name you want. I'll be using ROM1, and you click save. So we need three things: the region, start address, and the length. For the region, we'll be making the readback from the EMMC boot 1 region. And to get the start address and length, we go to the scatter file and we edit with notepad++. So for the start address to be 0x1, and for the length we'll be using the partition size. So you copy the partition size, and the start address is 0x1. So you go to SP Flash 2, start address 0x0, and the length will be 0x8000, and you click OK. So now we need to bypass secure boot. So go to the bypass utility master folder, and you open a window terminal in the folder. CMD. So you start the bypass process. So pi main dot pi, and you connect your device. So as you can see, put section is disabled. So now I can perform the read back. So I click on read back. So successful. So we need to perform two other read back, one to get the PGT file and for the whole dump. So we'll be using the PGT file to get the length of the whole dump. So to perform the PGT read back, we click on and we save it as ROM2. So the region for the PGT will be EMMC user. The start address and length will be the same for the preloader. So we go to the scatter file so we can get the partition size. And the start address is 0x0. So we click OK. So we run the bypass. Okay, I need to get the device. Device is stuck in preloader mode, so I need to get it out of preloader mode. I can continue with the tutorial. So my device has started, so I need to power it off. So I connect my device. As you can see, protection is disabled. And I can continue with the read back. So I have my PGT file. So I go back to WWR2. Then I click on select file and I will load the PGT file. So with the PGT file, we can get the address of the full ROM. Of the full dump. So this is the address of the full dump, but I will not perform a readback of the full dump, it will take too long. So if I want to perform readback of certain partitions, so let's say I want to perform a readback of PGT to boot A. So I'll go back to SP Flash 2. I can save the readback as ROM3. So the region will also be EMMC user, then the start address will be 0x0, then the length will be the start address of LAFA. So I can just copy the start address of LAFA and I'll paste it as the length. So I click OK. Then I will run the bypass utility again. So I connect my device. As you can see, protection is disabled. Then I can perform the readback. So we wait for the readback to finish. So as you can see, the readback is complete. But if you want to perform, let's say you want to perform a readback of system, readback of from the PGT to system, maybe you want to exclude user data and cache because they are large, so your length will be okay, let's say you want to perform a readback from PGT to super, your length will be the start address of OPA, which is this. Or if you want to perform a readback of the old dump, this will be the length. You use the length of the full volume of the PGT of the GPT. So I click on select file, then I select the ROM dump, which is the ROM 3. So as you can see, it has backup from the PGT to boot A. So I go back to auto mode, then I click on start autopilot. I untick this and tick identifying platform. Then I click on start process. So we wait for it. So to show us the platform, I click OK. So you can just call the ROM as it is. So you click on it. So you select a folder you want to save it. So I'll be saving it at bomb dump. And you click select folder. So as you can see, it's cutting all the partitions. So as we can see, it has dumped the partitions that I read. So this is everything.